Everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel. We are going to start activity 6.2 in this video. So let's read it first. Collect the chalk dust lying on the floor near the blackboard in your classroom or crush a small piece of chalk into dust. Add a little water to the dust to make a paste. Roll it into the shape of a piece of chalk. Let it dry. Did you recover chalk from the dust? So in this activity what we're gonna do is we have to collect the chalk dust lying on the floor near the blackboard, or you can also crush a small piece of chalk into dust, and then we have to add a little water to the dust to make a paste. Then after making the paste, we have to roll it into the shape of the piece of chalk, and then we have to let it dry. Did you recover chalk from the dust? Of course not. You cannot recover the chalk, as it has now a it has become a change now. It is not the its properties are changed. It's now can't be recovered back to a normal chalk. So then we have the activity 6.3. Then we have to take some ice in a glass or plastic tumbler, melt a small portion of ice by placing the tumbler in the sun. You now have a mixture of ice and water. Now place the tumbler in a freezing mixture, ice plus common salt. Does the water become solid ice once again? We have to take some ice in a glass tumbler, then we have to melt small portion of ice by placing tumbler in the sun. Then we have to make a mixture of ice and water. Now place the tumbler in a freezing mixture. Then ice plus common salt. Does the water become solid ice once again? So you have to do this activity on your own and find out the answer for this question. We have another activity, that is activity 6.4. Boil some water in a container. Do you see the steam rising from the surface of water? Hold an inverted pan by its handle over the steam at some distance from the boiling water. Observe the inner surface of the pan. Do you see any droplet of water there? We have to boil some water in a container, then we have to see the steam which is rising from the surface of the water, that it usually does. Then we have to hold an inverted pan by its handle over the steam at some distance. Observe the inner surface of the pan. Do you see any droplet of water there? Yes, you can definitely see, or you can perform the activity and you can find out the answer of this question too. So that's it for this video. Now we are going to start in the next activity in the next video. Till then, you just perform all these activities that we have discussed in this video.